Chapter 5, Charlotte. The night seemed long. Wilbur's stomach was empty and his mind was full. And when your stomach is empty and your mind is full, it's always hard to sleep. A dozen times during the night, Wilbur woke and stared into the blackness, listening to the sounds and trying to figure out what time it was. A barn is never perfectly quiet. Even at midnight, there's usually something stirring. The first time he woke up, he heard Templeton gnawing a hole in the grain bin. Templeton's teeth scraped loudly against the wood and made quite a racket. "That crazy rat," thought Wilbur. "Why does he have to stay up all night grinding his clashers and destroying people's property? Why can't he go to sleep like any decent animal?" The second time Wilbur woke up, he heard the goose turning on her nest and chuckling to herself. "What time is it?" whispered Wilbur to the goose. Probably about 11:30, said the goose. "Why aren't you asleep, Wilbur?" "Too many things on my mind," said Wilbur. "You guys, I want you to pause to stop and jot. Why do you think Wilbur is waking up so many times throughout the night? Why is his mind full? Go ahead and stop and jot." "Well," said the goose, "that's not my trouble. I have nothing at all on my mind, but I've got too many things under my behind. Have you ever tried to sleep while sitting on 8 eggs? "No," replied Wilbur. "I suppose it is uncomfortable. How long does it take a goose egg to hatch?" Approximately 30 days, all told," answered the goose. "You guys, I wonder if it really does take 30 days for eggs to hatch. I'm gonna have to look that up. "But I cheat a little. On warm afternoons, I just put a little straw over the eggs and go for a walk." Wilbur yawned and went back to sleep. In his dreams, he heard again the voice saying, "I'll be a friend to you. Go to sleep. You'll see me in the morning." About 30 minutes before dawn, Wilbur woke and listened. The barn was still dark. The sheep lay motionless. Even the goose was quiet. Overhead on the main floor, nothing stirred. The cows were resting, the horses dozed. Templeton had quit work and gone off somewhere on an errand. The only sound was a slight scraping noise from the rooftop, where the weather vane swung back and forth. Wilbur loved the barn when it was like this, calm and quiet, waiting for light. "Day is almost here," he thought. Ooh, he's really excited, you guys. If your stop and jot was that he was waking up and had a lot on his mind to meet Charlotte, I think so too, and I think he's pretty excited. I infer he's pretty excited. Through a small window, a faint gleam appeared. One by one, the stars went out. Wilbur could see the goose a few feet away. She sat with head tucked under a wing. Then he could see the sheep and... "Oh, beautiful day it is here at last. Today I shall find my friend." Wilbur looked everywhere. He searched his pen thoroughly. He examined the window ledge, staring up at the ceiling, but he saw nothing new. Finally, he decided he would have to speak up. He hated to break the lovely stillness of a dawn by using his voice, but he couldn't think of any other way to locate the mysterious new friend who was nowhere to be seen. So Wilbur cleared his throat. "Attention, please," he said in a loud, firm voice. "Will the party who addressed me at bedtime last night kindly make himself or herself known by giving an appropriate sign or signal?" Wilbur paused and listened. All the other animals lifted their head and stared at him. Wilbur blushed. So he's probably embarrassed, right? I infer he's embarrassed. But he was determined to get in touch with his unknown friend. "Attention, please," he said. "I will repeat the message. Will the party who addressed me at bedtime last night kindly speak up? Please tell me where you are, if you are my friend." The sheep looked at each other in disgust. "Stop your nonsense, Wilbur," said the oldest sheep. "If you have a new friend here, you are probably disturbing his rest. And the quickest way to spoil a friendship is to wake somebody up in the morning before he is ready. How can you be sure your friend is an early riser?" The sheep makes a good point, you guys. "I beg everyone's pardon," whispered Wilbur. "I didn't mean to be objectionable." So that means to be rude, you guys. He's being kind of rude, yelling at the top of his lungs before the sun has even come out. He lay down meekly in the manure facing the door. He did not know it, but his friend was very near. And the old sheep was right. The friend was still asleep. Soon, Lurvy appeared with slops for breakfast. Wilbur rushed out, ate everything in a hurry, and licked the trough. The sheep moved off down the lane. The gander waddled along behind them, pulling grass. And then, just as Wilbur was settling down for his morning nap, he heard again the thin voice that had addressed him the night before. "Salutations," said the voice. Wilbur jumped to his feet. "What?" he cried. "Salutations," repeated the voice. "What are they? And who are you?" screamed Wilbur. Please tell me where you are and what are salutations?" "Salutations are greetings," said the voice. "When I say salutations, it's my fancy way of saying hello or good morning." Ooh, that's a word that you guys can use. So in the morning when you wake up and you see someone, you can say salutations. Actually, it's a silly expression, and I'm surprised that I used it at all. As for my whereabouts, that's easy. Look up here in the corner of the doorway. Here I am. Look, I'm waving. At last, Wilbur saw the creature that had spoken to him in such a kindly way. Stretched across the upper part of the doorway was a big spider web. And hanging from the top of the web, head down, was a large gray spider. She was about the size of a gumdrop. She had eight legs, and she was waving one of them at Wilbur in friendly greeting. "See me now?" she asked. "Oh, yes, indeed," said Wilbur. "Yes, indeed. How are you? Good morning. Salutations. Very pleased to meet you. What is your name, please? May I have your name?"
"My name," said the spider, "is Charlotte."
"Charlotte what?" asked Wilbur eagerly.
"Charlotte A. Cavatica.
But just call me Charlotte."
"I think you're beautiful," said Wilbur.
"Well, I am pretty," replied Charlotte. "There's no denying that. Almost all spiders are rather nice looking. I'm not as flashy as some, but I'll do."
"I wish I could see you, Wilbur, as clearly as you can see me."
"Why can't you?" asked the pig. "I'm right here."
"Yes, but I'm nearsighted," replied Charlotte. "I've always been dreadfully nearsighted. It's good in some ways, not so good in others. Watch me wrap up my fly."